of people, nuclear officials met with the public today on the Treasure Coast. They discussed Florida's nuclear reactor sites and their readiness for disaster. Terry Parker was at that meeting at the St. Lucie County plant, and she joins us live with what she learned. Terry?
Tiffany, the Nuclear Regulatory Commission inspects the plants each year and issues a report. Today, they did that. For 2010, the St. Lucie County plant gets a green light. No issues found. But with Japan on many people's minds, there were plenty of questions about nuclear safety and could it happen here?
What we've seen in Japan is that now they're letting the radiation out into the ocean. So, you know, is that a possibility here?
People asked pointed questions, both of federal NRC officials and of FPL, about the safety of the nuclear plant. One big concern, how safe are FPL's used fuel rods? FPL has run out of room to keep all of its spent fuel in cooling tanks, and for several years has stored them in containers called dry casks.
It's our position that dry cask storage is a perfectly safe way. It's been the systems have been used for really since the nuclear industry began. So there's a spent fuel that's been on site, you know, 30 years or more.
Residents want to know if a hurricane or other disaster could damage the dry cask and release radioactive material.
Now, can you honestly tell me that you think that an evacuation could take place here with this site and get these people out of here?
FPL says dry storage has proved safe for 30 years.
For example, in the case of our Turkey Point plant in 1992, it got a direct hit from Hurricane Andrew and performed exactly as expected. Here at St. Lucie, Hurricanes Jean and Francis, one after another, hit this plant directly, and it survived just fine.
Some still weren't convinced and called some answers vague.
And you said if they need more water, they can just throw a hose in it, in the canal? I mean, to me, a hose in the canal isn't going to cool down a nuclear power plant.
The federal government is supposed to come up with a solution to the spent fuel problem, but so far it hasn't, which is why many nuclear plants have amended licenses to store the spent fuel on site.
Important thing to remember when we're talking about spent fuel is that the federal government actually was supposed to start assuming responsibility for the spent fuel about 13 years ago in 1998. Since that time, we and every other nuclear plant in the country has moved to an alternative solution, which in the case of St. Lucie plant is dry cask storage, which is a very safe, secure way to maintain the fuel for a longer period of time until the federal government decides exactly how they're going to dispose of it from a national policy perspective.
And the NRC says the St. Lucie County plant is also built high enough to withstand a tsunami or a Category 5 hurricane with no danger of water damaging the reactors or spent fuel storage. Reporting live in the studio, Terry Parker, WPBF 25 News.